Hello everyone, welcome back to iLLPHOCORPHICS. In today's tutorial, I will show you how to design a professional celebration flyer in Photoshop. I show you all the processes that you need to know how to design this party flyer in Photoshop. If you are a beginner or intermediate designer, I hope that you will like to make the design for yourself. So watch the tutorial until the end, and learn how can you also design this kind of design by yourself. And I would like to share my viewers and subscribers, I have launched my channel membership for everyone at just $3.99. If you are a member of my channel, you will get all the designer files of me including this design also. You will be able to get all the support from me, even direct contact with me. So be my channel member if my channel helped you to learn something. And also be sure to subscribe and press the bell icon so that you might never miss any chance to learn new things about Photoshop. Let's start today's tutorial. Now we are here in the magical world of Photoshop. I have downloaded this image from freepik.com. I have already removed the background from the image so that it makes the tutorial fast, and if you want to learn how to remove background, you can check out my tutorials on my channel. I hope you will find something good. Now first, we have to take a letter size document for the flyer. You can go with A4 size paper. So go to the file, new. And now you can see the letter size. If you don't find it here, go to print, and there you go, that printing letter size paper. Create the document. After creating the document, we need to create a gradient background. Go to the adjustments layer, and take gradient. After that, click on the gradient. Increase the opacity to 100%. Then change the color or the two size point. Choose any color that you want to use in the background. I will go with deep blue and cyan color. Hit OK. Then go to the toolbar and take the brush tool. Choose a magenta color and adjust the brush size and hardness and click. Make the color big, and put it in the right top corner. Hit OK. Next, we will add the model to the composition. Go to the model image document. Take the image, and paste it into the composition. Press Ctrl or Command plus T to open Free Transform. And then adjust the image and put it in the right place in the design. Then go to the adjustments layer, and take gradient. Choose a gradient like me. Then hit OK. Press the right button on your mouse, and create a clipping mask. Then change the blending mode into overlay. After that, again double click on the gradient, and make some adjustments to the gradient as you want. Hit OK. Then create a new layer. Take the brush tool. Choose a deep blue color. And apply the color to the bottom. Then change the blending mode into the color burn. And then decrease the opacity a little bit. After finishing the background and model, we need to give some contrast to the design. Go to the adjustments layer, and take brightness and contrast. Increase the contrast, also increase the brightness a little bit. Next, select the bottom layer of the model, and then take the ellipse tool. Then make a perfect circle back to the model head. Then adjust the model size again a little bit. Then double click on the ellipse layer. It will open the layer style option. Then apply a gradient to the circle. Adjust the gradient properly as like me. Hit OK. Then press Ctrl or Command plus J to make a duplicate layer. Delete the layer effects. Open the properties. If you don't find it here, go to the window and properties. Then change the fill color into the none and use 20 pixels white stroke. Press Ctrl or Command plus T and make the circle size smaller. Choose ellipse tool, go to the options bar, and here you will find more options for stroke. Use round caps, then open. Now we will apply the dash. Use 100 size dash and 10 size gap. Hit OK. Now we will make duplicates layer of the stroke, and then make the size smaller. Also make some adjustments to make it look good. Do the same process until the circle design is properly done. After completing the design, select all the ellipse layer. And then create a group. Give a name also to the group. Now after that, we will add our text and the shapes for the final design. You can just follow all of my steps. First, take the type tool. And add all the text information that you want to use in the design. You don't need to be perfect. We will customize the text later. Now first we will customize the bottom text for the design. Use the same shape and then customize them also. After that, customize other text information of the design properly. Follow my steps to do the process. Now we are done with the design. For the final touch, we will add some design elements to make the design more good looking. So follow my steps to create the design elements like me. Create X shape with the rectangle. Merge the shape. Merge the shape. Press Alt or Option, and put it in the other corner. Take the ellipse tool, and make a shape like me. Copy the shape by pressing the Alt or Option on your keyboard. Then put it in a different area by copying it. Also, change the blending mode of the layers. Now it's done. After all the design, organize the layers by making groups. It makes the design more professional. So now we are done. You can see I just show you all the process to design a professional flyer in Photoshop. I hope that you like the design. Let's see our final output. Now, I just show you all the process to design a professional celebration flyer in Photoshop. I try to show and explain all the necessary steps that you need to do to make the design as perfect looking as possible. If you follow my steps, I hope that you might be able to design a design like me. So thank you so much for watching until the end. If you like the tutorial, hit that like button. If you have any request design tutorials, let me know in the comment section below. And share the tutorial with your friends to help my channel grow. And if you like my work, you can support my work and join my channel membership. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Not just subscribe, also press the bell icon, so that you get all the notifications of my channel and don't miss any chance to learn new things about Photoshop. So that's it for today. See you in my next tutorial. Till then, bye. And the most important thing, keep learning.